Please stand for the pledges. I pledge allegiance to the American flag. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I pledge to the Christian flag. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for his kingdom it stands. One Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life everlasting for all who believe.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible. Ready, begin. Please bow your heads and close your eyes. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you that we're all here. I pray that we'll have an awesome summer and an awesome rest of the school year. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. Our class has memorized several historical documents this year, including the preamble to the United States Constitution, which we are going to say for you.
First Amendment to the Constitution.
Okay, well, thank you all for coming, and we're so glad we could be able to do this. One thing that we weren't able to do this year is have you all join us for our Philippians Award. Normally, we do that during the chapel times, and so we thought it important to let you all know who won our Philippians Award. So as I call your name, fifth graders, you'll stand, and then after each group, we'll go ahead and give all of them a round of applause. So for our first quality characteristic, we had respect, and the winners of that were Leah Juntwaite, Raylan Dickinson, and Brooklyn Farmer. So if you guys could stand, and let's give them a round of applause. Okay, and then next we had our Hospitality Award, and that was given to Mandy Mossett, Chloe Avalanites, Jesse Daniel, and Ninoa Metrovich. Great job, guys. And then we had our Dependability Award, and that was given to Isaac Dixon, Henry Grenner, and Nadia Sundquist. Great job, guys. And then we had our Diligence Award, and that was given to Sabina Daniel, Emily Riker, and Lindy Shen. Great job, girls. And then we had our Sincerity Award, and that was given to David Schopf, Dak Lamb, and Elizabeth Pinkerton. Great job, guys. And then we had our Thoroughness Award, and that was given to Jacob Hamrich and Krista Ness. Great job, guys. And then we had our Conservation Award, and that was given to Annika Little, Keturah Montaigne, Fatima Gohar, and Grady Harriman. Good job, guys. And then our last one of the year was the Honesty Award, and that was given to Keenan Petkovich, Molly Olson, Nick Pellegrini. That got excited. And Jacob Yao. Good job, guys. All right, and now you're going to hear some Bible memorization.
This year, our class studied the book of James, and here are some of the verses we learned from James 1.
James 3, 5, 7 through 10, and 13.
I should have clued into my daughter's look when I came up here the first time because I was up here too soon. So now is the fun time to go ahead and honor all of our graduates from fifth grade. So I'm going to go ahead and call their name, and they're going to get a certificate from me, and then they're going to go either side. So parents, this is an opportunity for the photo with their teachers on either side. And they're going to get these amazing, Mrs. Goodell, can you show them? It's their fifth grade, it's actually their middle school survival kit. And it's two amazing moms came up with this idea and we put this together. So this is where we're gonna go. So get your cameras ready for them to go forward. All right, our first graduate is Chloe Avlontes. Come on up. And you can't really show. Our next one is Jesse Daniel. I like your jacket. Ready to go on the other side. Next one is Sabina Daniel. Congratulations, sweetie. And Brooklyn Farmer. Here you go, sweetie. Oh, picture opportunity. And Raylan Dickinson. And Fatima Gohar. Congratulations, sweetie. Oh, not today. Isaac Dixon. There you go, buddy. Congratulations. Henry Grenner. There you go, buddy. Congratulations. and Jacob Hamrich. Nice job, buddy. Yeah. Grady Harriman.
The shoes.
Leah Juntwait.
Congratulations.
Dak Lamb.
Congratulations, buddy.
Nope. Annika Little.
There you go, sweetie. Congratulations. Oh.
Nainoa Metrovich. Nice job, buddy. Katura Montaigne. Congratulations, sweetie. Krista Ness.
Congratulations, sweetie.
And Mandy Mossett. Nick Pellegrini.
Congratulations, buddy. Oh, there we go.
Molly Olson.
Congratulations, sweetie. Oh, there we go. Yep.
Oh. Elizabeth Pinkerton.
There we go. Yes.
Kenan Pekovich.
Congratulations, buddy.
Lindy Shen.
Congratulations, sweetie.
Emily Riker.
Hey, sweetie. Congratulations.
Nadia Sundquist.
Thank you. I'm going to shake that hand. There we go.
And David Schaff.
Congratulations, buddy.
And Jacob Yo.
Congratulations, buddy.
So a big thank you to a group of people that we kind of came up with this idea about a month ago and when things started opening back up, and it was just something that we really felt led to do. So this is our first of many more to come for fifth grade celebrations of HCA. And a big thank you to Christy Ronigan, wherever she's at, for taking on and doing the music. Greatly appreciate it. And Kristen Avalenti right there. This lady is behind the scenes, always putting everything together. Susie Wolf and Patty Mai up there, if they're wave. They've been, we kind of added this on to kindergarten. Most of you don't know, but we had kindergarten graduation this morning. Those two have been working their tails off. So a big thank you to you guys. And Kendra Farmer and Riley Sunquest for just coming alongside and doing some of the pictures, as well as helping out the party this afternoon at the park. So more than anything, we just can't thank you guys all enough. We wouldn't be here without your support. This year has definitely been different, but so many blessings, so many God blessings this year. I'm gonna pass it off to my two amazing teachers, because without them, your kids wouldn't have been guided this year, and they're gonna just give you a glimpse of what it was like in fifth grade this year, and then close us out in prayer.
Okay, thank you. I'm Suzanne Goodheil, and for those of you who know me, I can be long-winded. So I'm sorry, but I am going to take this opportunity to say a few words today because I am retiring. This is it for me. I can't believe it. 38 years I've been doing this, and it's been such a blessing in my life. Come September, I'm going to be bawling my head off. I'm sure I'll be calling Stephanie, what's everybody doing? It'll be so strange for me not to be back in a classroom. But I'm sure I'll find other things to fill my time. I want to take this opportunity to say thank you. If it weren't for you, parents and grandparents, investing in your kids and sending them to Christian education. I'm sorry, I'm getting choked up. It's the best thing you can do for your children. Because one thing I learned a long time ago is you don't get any do-overs. You get one shot at raising your kids, and you want to do it right, and you want to do it with God's guidance. And that's what you're doing. That's what you're doing here at HCA. And so I commend you, all of you. I hope you noticed when we opened the ceremony, we pledged the flag of the United States of America. We teach these kids that this is a wonderful country, and we love this country. We love the principles that it's founded upon. We love the Lord. We start every single day in our classroom with pledges and prayer. And that's important, and we will never get away from that. That is something that will always stay at this school. So again, I just commend you for bringing your kids here, keeping your kids here. I know it's tough. My husband and I did it. We put our three kids all through Christian education. It was a sacrifice financially, but you know what? All three of them are they've grown up. They've got families of their own. I'm a grandma now, and I would not have done one thing differently. So, you know, you don't need the super fancy new cars. You don't need the vacations. What you need to do is bring good, godly people into this world that will go out and affect other people. Yes. So thank you, thank you, thank you for doing that for your kids. So even though this year looked different, your kids are resilient. We got used to the masks. Do we love them? No. But we wore them because we knew we had to in order to be here. And it was worth it. Worth every minute of it. We sat with our desks 6 feet apart. We cleaned. My goodness, my kids cleaned their desks more this year than I've ever cleaned my entire house. I mean, it's unbelievable. My room was so clean, the janitor thanked me. She's like, Suzanne, you have the cleanest room, and it always smells so disinfected. I'm like, thank you. Yeah. So we stayed healthy. We did our best, and we did it. We did it. And we were here all year. Think of all the children in this country and around the world that didn't get to go to school every day. That breaks my heart. So thank you again for sending your children here to be with us every single day. We loved it. We laughed a lot in fifth grade, didn't we? Yes, we did. We learned a lot. Oh my gosh, we were so busy this year. So Mrs. Hancock and I were just gonna give you a very small, teeny tiny glimpse into some of the things that your kids learned this year. So in Bible this year, we did 4 inductive Bible studies. We learned about James. We learned all about Esther, all about Daniel. And then we learned about all the different names for God. We prayed every single day in our classrooms, and a lot of you were in those prayers. Okay? We memorized a lot of scripture this year. And during testing week, we have a thing called the legacy curriculum. And in that legacy curriculum, we talked about how God uniquely created man and uniquely created woman. And that's it, man and woman. And we talked about the different roles that God created us for, and it was very, very enlightening. Mrs. Hancock.
Hi, I'm Becky Hancock, and if you know me, you know I'm not long-winded. So, yeah.
We're opposite.
It takes all kinds, right? All right. In history this year, you heard some of the historic documents that we memorized. We memorized many of them, and the longest of them was the Declaration of Independence. It would be interesting to see if your students still know them. So you might ask them on their drive home if they can still quote the Declaration. We started the year with a unit of study on your family histories that I hope you all learned something new by going through that too with your student. We heard some great family stories. It was a great way to get to know your kids. Then we mostly spent our time in U.S. history. We started with the World Wars and went up to the year 2000. So we brought them pretty current in our history studies. One of the major projects, you either love it or hate it, was the Nation Notebook. Yeah. So, kids, do you remember what country you studied and reported on? Okay. I'm going to count to three, and I want you to tell everyone what country it was. You ready? One, two, three. Okay.
Got that? Yeah. Okay, science. This year in science, we studied about geology, fossils, dinosaurs, ecosystems, energy and heat, biomes, the respiratory system, the circulatory system. The students wrote short reports about different vertebrates and invertebrates, and they went into the science lab every other week where the science lab teacher then would piggyback onto what we were doing in the classroom and she would do some of the experiments with them. So we learned a lot in science this year.
We did a lot of writing too, and I know a lot of you were busy acting as proofreaders for that writing.
Yes,
thank you so much. They wrote reports in history, they wrote reports in science, and then we did some creative writing. So I'm going to remind you of some of that creative writing that we did way back early in winter. You all wrote stories about a scarecrow. Do you remember the scarecrow? Yeah? And then they used picture prompts from a Harris Burdick book, and they all wrote different stories based on those picture prompts. The most recent story they did was a cautionary tale about never mailing a particular creature. They all came up with their own animals, some mythical, some real, and told about the dangers of trying to mail that. I'm curious, students, do you feel like you're a better writer now than you were a year ago? Raise your hand if that would be true of you. Do you feel you're better at writing? Yeah, nice.
Yeah, we really focused on that this year, and so that's nice to see. So I just want to close us out by giving you a few reminders and praying with you. A few reminders. So in the back, when we're finished here, are some refreshments. So please, families, you know, stick around. I know you haven't had a chance to see each other or talk a lot this year, so it would be nice for you guys to get caught up with each other. Be nice to take pictures with the kids. So in the back, outside the doors, right, Kristen? Yeah, so you can grab a snack. The students all brought their things up from their classroom, so that all their things are out there. So when you go to leave today, make sure your student grabs their backpack and their bags full of books and all those other fun goodies. And then there is another celebration being held at Stipic Park, which is right here in Bothell, down the road, just a mile or two. And they would love to see you there. And I think it's okay for you to, when you leave here, to just head out and go straight there and just meet at the park. Is that right? Yeah. If you have other children and they get out at 2:45, please arrange for someone to get them. Yes. Or, yeah, drop off your fifth grader and then come back. You can always do that, too. Yeah. So we would love to see you there. Mrs. Hancock and I will make a special guest appearance at the park. Yeah. Yes. Again, just a chance for us to mingle and catch up and be outside on a really nice day today. So, yay. All right. If you don't mind, would you please bow your heads, close your eyes, and I will lead us out in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you so, so much, God. I thank you for these parents and grandparents and friends sitting in this room that have supported these fifth graders all year long, God. What a blessing. And what a blessing these fifth graders have been to Mrs. Hancock and I. Mrs. Hancock and I have had the pleasure of having many of them for 2 years in a row now. And we really know these kids, and we love, love, love your kids. We will miss them. We know they are well prepared for middle school, God. We know that you are watching over them. I just pray for their summer, that everybody stays healthy and safe, and that they all come back next year with huge smiles on their faces, ready to learn. We praise you, God. We love you, God. And in all these things, we pray. And everyone said,
amen.
So you are free to go.